Welcome back to the World Indoor Championships here in Belgrade, and what an evening we have in store for you with the men's shot put final.
It is time for the men's shot put final.
Vreme je za finale u bacanju kugle.
Italy. Michelle Haratic, Poland. Zane Weir for Italy. Victor Pettersson, Sweden. Andre Tuada, Romania. Filip Mihailovic, Croatia. Kolber Temiz, Luxembourg. Josh Awatundi, USA. Scott Lincoln, Great Britain. Tajinder Pal Tour, India. Tomasz Danek, Czech Republic. Francisco Bello, Portugal. Next, the European silver medalist for Poland.
Jeden od favorita dolazi nam iz Polski.
Konrad Bogowiecki. Next, the national champion of Serbia.
A sada, naš šampion, Asmir Kolašina.
Next, the South American champion for Brazil.
Iz Brazila, šampion Južne Amerike.
Dalan Romani. Next, the defending world indoor champion for New Zealand.
Branilac titule sa Novog Zelanda.
Tom Walsh. And the Olympic champion and world record holder for USA.
I olimpijski šampion i svetski rekorder iz Sjedinjenih Američkih Država.
Ryan Krauser. This is the men's shot put final.
18 najboljih u finalu bacanja kugle.
And here we go, the men's shot put final. Ryan Krauser there, favorite for this event this evening, but there are many people who can stand in his way of that gold medal, his first World Indoor Championships. 18 athletes in the field, all getting three attempts, the top eight getting a further three. Just getting the final preparations together before we get the competition underway. Incredible scenes here, full stadium. And there is your starting lineup. Mesut Pezet will be getting her underway, followed by Asmir Kolašinets of Serbia. 18 athletes in the field, and they will be closed out by Francisco Bello of Portugal. All 18 athletes getting three attempts. Top eight will then be in reverse order and have a further three to fight it out for the medals. And there, Tom Walsh. But competition getting underway. And Mesut Pezet will get the proceedings going. The season's best. That's a good start for Mesut. Always important to get that first round in, settle the nerves, settle into the competition, give yourself something to build on. Comes around really well there. Maybe just missed it on the tips of his fingers. But a positive start. 20.64 then, his first distance on the board. We will see Asmir Kolishnets of Serbia into the ring next. And I'm sure this crowd are going to be behind him. ...37 years old now, the 2013 European indoor champion, taking every opportunity to compete in front of a home crowd. Just letting it go a bit early there. Really has good support in this arena. Has gone 21.06 indoors. ...20.64 for him in the first round, matching Pezzer distance exactly. Nick Ponzio, though, will be next. Allegiance transferee from USA, now competing for Italy. He's coming to this in fine form, producing 21.61 here in Belgrade just a couple of weeks ago. What will he open his account with? Catches that. He's happy with it. One of the shortest men in the field, but also one of the most powerful. Doesn't quite come through as well as he can. It's a foul. Unfortunately for him, we'll have to wait to the second round before he can get a mark.
I didn't feel it. I thought I hit it, but I mean...
I believe he's protesting the distance.
Kind of hung on in there.
We saw Sarah Mitten having similar problems in the women's shot, but it's that reverse leg will open his account. What can the European champion produce? That's a good start.
Good.
The red flag is raised, though. Comes off the back well. Oh, yes. Couldn't quite keep his body weight in the ring. When you're producing that much force and power, it's always hard to control it. That's a big throw in the tank, though. Have to wait for the second round to get ratified distance. Thomas Walsh, though, the defending indoor champion, produced a championship best to win it back in Birmingham. What can this man do? And what a throw from Thomas Walsh. Phenomenal effort. In the first round, sails comfortably over that 22-meter mark. technically is phenomenal. Hits it, isn't quite in the positions that we've seen before, but still able to produce 22-29. It's a great start and has definitely put the pressure on Ryan Krauser. ...22.51 for Ryan this year. The world indoor record holder of 22.82. The outdoor record holder also going over that 23 meter mark. Has become an absolute pioneer in this event. But believe it or not, his first world indoor championships. Ryan Krauser then, first round attempt. Really patient on that, and it's another 22 meter throw. These gentlemen ain't hanging about. Going off straight from the start. Phenomenal to see. Has so much contact time on that shot put. Stays so far behind it. Holds the wrap so well. And 22.44, that is a championship record already. We knew it was going to go. Didn't expect to see so many fireworks in the first round, especially after four throwers. We are in for a treat. Zane Weir then, another allegiance transferee to Italy. He's gone 21.50 indoors this year. That's a good start. The white flag is raised. Gets so much linear speed, just missed connection. Timing a bit off. So he's definitely got a bigger throw in him.
Very easy, yeah.
21.34.
I think it's like 21.10. He's trying to get it organized.
Teammate Nick Ponzio there. Saying very easy throw, and it was indeed. Victor Pettersson of Sweden. Finessing to the ring. 20.73 the season so far. Start. It's around this season's best. Big wide right leg out the back. ...20.33. We need to build rapidly to get close to Walsh and Krauser. Andre Toda from Adia next into the ring. The youngest in the field. Just a bit down there. Nose didn't quite connect with it. Just let the ball go early. ...19.10. It's a first round attempt. Filip Melihelovic. Joint tallest man in the field. Has produced 21.84 this year. Just awaiting the officials permission to enter the ring. When that cone's removed, athletes get a minute to produce their throw, which is usually over in seconds. As we're coming up to halfway through the field of the first round attempts. Cone remove. Nel Helovic to open his account. Warrior patient at the back. That's a good start. He's happy with that. ...2021 European Indoor Bronze Medalist. Starts well. That's definitely close to what he's done this year. 21-51. Puts him in third place overall. You'll be happy with that. Just getting a bit of feedback from Tom Walsh. Bob Bertams then, of Luxembourg. ...20.91 this season so far. The Luxembourg record holder. Happy to get that white flag. Lands just over that 20-meter line. Had a great season in 2019. Going from 21 meters to breaking that 22-meter barrier. But opens his account with 20 meters 10 today. Josh Awatunde next into the ring. Second at the US trials behind Ryan Krauser. 21-74, the season's best. Good start. White flag's raised. Not giving anything away. It's nice and low. Comes up high. ...20.74. Konrad Bukovetsky. Second in the world this year with 20.91. That throw just a few weeks ago in Madrid. What can he open with today? He just lost it on the finish there. He knows that. The white flag is raised. Just shy of that 20-meter mark. Just well out the back. Just comes through a little early. Collapsing on the right side. Plenty to improve on there. 19.79 for Konrad. Will seem a little frustrated with that, but still has another two throws before those knockouts. Scotty Lincoln then. British champion, 20.73. He's really had a breakthrough year last year. Just white flag is raised, just a little shy, 19 meters I think. Knows he did a couple of things wrong there. Over to Paul Wilson, his coach, for a little feedback. 19.33 for Scott Lincoln.
Thank you.
Bramani, 140 kilo mountain of a man, 21-71 this season, fourth at Rio, fourth in Doha, and fourth in Tokyo. We'll be looking to upgrade that today. And there we go, it's a good start from Darlan. It's out towards his season's best. Very popular thrower, and very, very popular back in Brazil. ...21.74. It's a 3 centimeter season's best for him. A great start. And a good distance to build on. Tejinder Pal Tour. Vindhya. The reigning Asian Games champion. And Asian record holder. Just flying out the front there. Not quite getting the right angles up the back.
It takes so long to finally get to where you are right now.
Left, right foot coming down a bit late.
I'm sure you're really happy that everything's paid off.
We'll have to wait for the second round to get a registered mark. Thomas Stanek.
You guys are among the best athletes in the world. So it was super.
The 2021 European indoor champion, national record holder, came third the world indoor champs back in Birmingham. It's from 21-18 this season. It's gone 22 meters indoors though. We'll need that today.
Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for the world champion.
So much speed, Thomas Stanek. Fortunately, not getting the linear speed he needed there. And the shot put coming down around 18 meters, well below par. Takes the foot foul and moves on. Francisco Bello of Portugal will be next into the ring. Loves creating some noise. Foul there for Stanek, just confirmed. He's very frustrated. Francisco Bello to complete the first round. 2064 this season. The 2017 World Student Games champion. Just shy of that 20 meter line. Rhythm, timing, crucial. A rotational shot put. All 18 throwers to date being rotational throwers. Very different to 20 years ago. I guess you have to spin to win. Brian Krauser, our leader so far. He's gone 22-44, already breaking that championship record. We'll be looking to improve his world leading mark of 22.51. Thomas Walsh there, renowned for producing that first round big throw. Also the only athlete to go over 22 so far. Let's get the second round underway. There's a peasant looking to improve on his 20 meters 64. Another consistent throw. Feels he's just missing it. Just losing connection a bit. Meters 94, it is a slight improvement. And a season's best. Judging by his frustration, he's definitely here in good form. Serbian crowd, big, big fan of Lazmir Kolašinac, as he will be looking to improve on his 2064. Second round. ...2013 European indoor champion. Just a bit impatient on the hit. And the red flag is raised. Hard to harness that adrenaline, especially when you have a home crowd behind you. You can just see rhythm not quite there. There's a great opportunity here to produce a lifetime best. Foul for Kolašinac. The second round. One remaining attempt, currently in eighth place overall. Nick Ponzio then, the allegiance transferee from the USA, Italian indoor champion this year and last year. Through 21-61 in Belgrade a couple of weeks ago. Holds himself in the ring. The white flag. Raised. Having that foul in the first one. Does much better there. Heel nowhere near the top. Stays in the ring. Fist raised. He's happy with it. 21-15 for him then. We'll be happy to get a mark on the board. Mikhail Havertik will be following him. European indoor champion in 2019. Polish record holder. Foul in the first round, so we'll need a registered mark here. The white flag is raised, gets the valid mark. Might have been a bit safe there. You can see he doesn't really get much out the back. Kind of goes through the motions. Next video on the finish and manages to pull 20-42. We'll know he has much bigger throws in the tank though. Thomas Walsh, 22-29 in the first round. The two-time Olympic bronze medalist, of course, in that epic 2019 World Championship shot put final. He's going to need to go big here to contend with Krauser. It's another big hit. Feels he might have just missed on it. Knows it wasn't over that 22-meter mark, so doesn't even bother looking at it. Such a good right leg out the back. High knee. Comes in, holds the rack. Yeah, athletes always know if it's going to be a big throw or not as soon as it leaves the fingertips. feels it may have been a very rotational rather than linear. Ryan Krauser then, next into the ring. 22-44 in the first round. Already taken Thomas Walsh's championship record. Can he threaten his own world indoor record of 22-82? Just losing it a bit there. White flag is raised, but he knows. Ryan's so consistent. He knew straight away as soon as it left his hand. Wasn't as good as his first round attempt. 21-55. For Ryan in the second. No improvement, still leading the competition. Same Weir, 21-34 for him in the first. Currently sat in fifth overall. Very explosive, couldn't quite keep it in the ring. Ends up putting it down out of the sector, but also falling out of the ring himself. Only in the shot, but down to the right. Falling out of the ring. It's a foul. 21-34, still his best. Victor Pettersson of Sweden. 20-33 in the first. Can he build on it? Not as far as his first round throw. Red flag is raised. Knows. No improvement. Just cutting things a bit short. And he lands at the front. Purposely foot fouling. Not even wanting it measured. No, it wasn't improvement. We'll have to wait until the third and final round to see if he can propel himself into that top eight. Andre Toda, 19-10. So far, could be a slight improvement. Not really being as long at the back, cutting it in short. Not giving that shot but as much contact time as he could. 19-60 though, it is a slight improvement for him. Still in 15th overall. He's going to need a lot more if he wants to make that top eight. Filip Melhalovic. Starting the competition very well. 21-51 in the first round. He currently has the third furthest mark this year of 21-84. Standing at over 2 meters tall. It's great to see him in this field being competitive. Just awaiting the officials' orders. Here we go. Filip Melhalovic, his second round attempt. Great to see the supporters in the crowd. Full arena tonight. Tremendous atmosphere in here. And the Shopper is definitely using it.
No improvement there.
He knows that. Gets out the back better, though. Just a bit of timing missing. Looks around the 21-meter mark. 21.05 then for Mel Helovic. It's no improvement. Still in fourth place overall. Bob Bertens of Luxembourg. Need a big throw here. He wants to get in that top eight. Struggles to stay in the ring, produced so much force going forward. Red flag is raised. Flies out the front of the ring. Loads that left well at the back. But no improvement. Still in 12th place. He's going to need to produce close to his season's best if he wants to get in that top eight. Josh Owatunde, 20.74 in that first round. Be looking to build on this. What can he do? That's much better, just inside that sector. Really well there to stay in the ring. Looks like it could be a slight improvement. Discussions currently going on as to where it landed, as it was so close to the sector line. The indoor sector, of course, different to the outdoor sector. The sector squares off a much shorter distance.
Clear as day. That hit the fucking pad. How about a foul? Yeah. Hey, good job.
It's hard to see if it landed on the line or not. You can sense Josh Owatunde's frustration. He's adamant that's in and it's a legal throw. 21-41 for him. A much better throw. Great improvement. Puts himself up to fifth. Konrad Bukovetsky needs a greatly improved throw here. What can he do? That's better. Still not quite pulling it all together. Not quite getting over that right. Left leg comes down, hits it well though. Knows what he needs to do. Conversing with his coach. 20.79 in ninth place. He's going to need to go a bit further if he wants to make that top eight. Has one remaining attempt. Scott Lincoln of Great Britain. Thirteen unbeaten successive UK championships. Need to improve on his 1933. Really is a hands on hip moment for him. You can sense his frustration there. The white flag is raised though. Does Gray out the back. Just snatched to the finish. You can sense there's a big throw there. Just needs a bit more patience. ...19.45 for him. It's a slight improvement. Darlan Romani, 21.74 in that first round. Currently in the bronze medal position overall. Still early days. And he builds on that in his second round attempt. those piercing eyes. It's another big throw from Darlan Romani. The white flag is raised. That will be an improvement for him. Creeping up on that 22-meter line. You feel he's going to need a 22-meter throw today to stay in that bronze medal position. He's definitely heading in the right direction. 21.79. 5-centimeter improvement. Putting together a consistent series of throws. Dushinder Paltor of India, foul in the first round. He's going to need to produce a lifetime best here to get in the top eight, but his left foot just coming down. His right foot landing outside the circle. Left foot, sorry, as he switched foot at the finish. Not really using that stop foot like he could be. Has put a lot of pressure on himself going into that third attempt now. Looking for some wise words from his coach. Tomáš Staněk. Czech Republic. Through 21.44 for the bronze medal. Back in Birmingham. He's going to need a distance greater than that today. White flag is raised. He has got a valid mark. No, he doesn't seem happy with it. Very rushed. Has so much speed and power. Just needs to harness it. You can see him back at those 22 meter distances. 19 meters 93 from Staněk. Having a difficult day in the office so far. In 14th place overall. Francisco Bello will complete the second round. 19.87, his best so far. Works as a doctor in Lisbon. Very talented individual. Struggling to put together a good throw here today. It's a foul. Still in 15th place overall. We have one remaining attempt to make that top eight. Always see athletes when they go after the throw, they drill a certain movement. Always. And always sense where they made the mistake. Event leader, Ryan Krauser. Looking calm and composed as ever. So we get the third round underway. Nezid Pezza of Bosnia and Herzegovina. Dragging that shot put across the back of his neck. Out of the sector, will be a red flag. Needs to be a bit more patient at the finish. Just see him not pushing through as well with the right leg. Hence the shot going down the right-hand side of the sector. Athletes staying nimble, staying warm. Just untangling the shot from the net. I guess what, that's their job. As we await Asmir Kolishnets will be entering the ring next of Serbia. Mezid Peza, though, it's a foul for him, has now got a long wait to see if 20 meters 94 is good enough to stay in that eighth position and make the final three throws. Let's hear the arena erupt then. Time to go big or go home. Asmir Kolishnets. Unfortunately, it's not to be. You can sense his disappointment and frustration. Would have wanted to put on a show today. It's not good enough to make that top eight. Just opening everything up with that left arm. When you've got that much excitement and adrenaline, it's always hard to harness it. Unfortunately, today's not his day. Nick Ponzio. Great character on the scene. Looks like another consistent 21 meter throw. Big right leg. Really good hit at the finish. You can see the double fist pump. Feels like he connected with that. It won't be an improvement. Sitting in seventh position so far. Should be enough to make that top eight. Would have liked to have made sure he'd thrown a bit further though. Mikhail Haratek of Poland, 20 meters 42 so far, sitting in 11th place. We'll have to improve here. We'll need to go 21 meters. Looks like a better throw. It's definitely slight improvement, I think. White flag is raised. Not sure if it's going to be enough to get him in that top eight. He knows. Just missed the connection. 20 meters 88. It is a slight improvement, but only good for ninth overall. That's the end of his competition. Thomas Walsh then, 22-29 in the first round, currently in second place overall. The time has gone. Cones removed. It's time for Tom Walsh's third round attempt. What can the defending indoor champion do? He's going to need to go bigger if he wants to defend that title. A big throw from Thomas Walsh. Just shy of that 22 meter barrier. The white flag is raised. Hit some incredible angles throughout that circle. An absolute technician. has a lot of accolades, a championship performer. There's no improvement though, 21.78. Still hot on the heels of Ryan Krauser, who is leading the way and next into the ring. 22.44. Set down a marker early on. Couldn't build on it in the second, but what has he got in the third? Athletes chalking up the shot and the neck, making sure they keep the grip. It's vital. Ryan, technically majestic throw it. Has really taken the event
to another level.
Breaking the outdoor world record of Randy Barnes. There's never been a world champion, indoors or out.
Will that change today? Leading the competition so far.
Walks out to the sector, waiting the officials' orders. Ryan Krauser then in USA. Can he build? Can he threaten that world indoor record? Another big throw from Ryan Krauser. Close to that 22-meter barrier. It won't be an improvement. Seeming a little frustrated with that one. A man who is capable of throwing 23 meters today. 21.86 though. No improvement for him, but he is still event leader in that top eight, who will get a further three to fight it out for the medals. Zane Weir strapping the wrist, ensuring there's no chalk or anything in the ring that can make him slip. Looks like a better throw, but unfortunately flies out the front. Red flag is raised. Much better technically. .21.34 is best though, still in sixth place overall. Victor Pettersson, 20.33 so far. He's going to need to pull something out here if he wants to get in that top eight. It's not to be for Victor Pettersson. 20.33, his best to date, red flag raised. And that'll be the end of his competition. Has a great wide right leg out the back. Still very young in this event. 23 years old, so won't be the last we see of him. Six-time Swedish champion. Andre Toda then of Romania, 19.60 so far.
No improvement for Toda. And that is the end of his competition. Meters 33, 1960 his best today, that came in the second round, 16th position overall. It's not enough to make that top eight. Filip Melhalovic to follow then, asking for the crowd support. What can the big Croatian do? Falls out the front, unfortunately. It does land over that 22-meter line, but it will not count. 21-51 so far. They had a lot of momentum going forward then. Shows he has a big throw in the tank. We'll get another three throws to see if he can produce it legally. Foul there, though. Still in fourth place overall. Bob Bertens, 20 meters 10. He's going to need a big, big throw here for him. Can he do? Over that 20-meter line, unfortunately. Red flag is raised too. No improvement. 13th place overall. It's the end of his competition. He knew it wasn't enough. Just walked straight out the front. Very frustrating afternoon for him. We'll be going back to Mannheim to see if he can figure out the errors. But Josh Awatunde into the ring now. Putting it down that left side of the sector. That's a big throw from Josh Awatunde. Looks like it's an improvement. Happy with that. Does really well there. Great finish. Come on up, man. 20.74, his best this season. That looks like it could be close to it. Meters 70, and he's put himself up into fourth place. Konrad Bukovetsky in danger of going out here, and puts that into the side netting. It's not a good day in the office for Konrad. 20.79, his best. Sat in 10th place, that's the end of his competition. And you can tell he's disappointed. A lot of technical errors there. Foul, 10th place overall. Scott Lincoln then, time for him to step up here. Looks like another 19.5 meter throw. Hasn't been able to show 20-meter form today. Looks very frustrated. And that's the end of his competition, unfortunately. It is an improvement, 19 meters 65, but only good enough for 16th place overall. Darlan Romani then, building a solid series of throws. edging up closely to that 22-meter mark. 21.79 in the last round. What can Dalam Rahmani produce in this third? Another huge throw from Dalam Rahmani over that 22-meter mark. The white flag is raised. Looks like he's joining the party with Thomas Walsh and Ryan Krauser. Meters is definitely there, waiting the mark, looks very happy with it. 22.53, he takes the lead from Krauser. What a throw! That is huge from Dalam Rahmani. Always brings it when it matters, but so does everyone else. Is today his day? Tejinder Singh Pal then, the follow of India. That's a much better throw from him. Stays in the ring. Knows he's not far enough to make that top eight. Takes the deliberate foul. It's three fouls for him today. And that's the end of his competition. Tejinder Singh Pal of India. There's Thomas Stanek then. 19 meters 93 so far, in danger of going out. The European champion is going to need to produce season's best here. What can Thomas Stanek do? 19 meters 93 so far, in 14th place. He's going to need meter or more to make that top eight. Oh, he just misses it, and he knows, throws his head backwards. Red flag is raised, and that is the end of his competition, sadly. Just didn't quite show his form today. It's written on his face. They'll have to regather, come back in the outdoor season. Francisco Bello then of Portugal, 1987. He'll have to pull something special out here if he wants to stay in this competition. Unfortunately, that's not it. Loses balance, couldn't even stay in the ring. 1987, his best to date. Good enough for 15th overall. That completes the third round. And what fireworks we have seen. Francisco Bello there, of Portugal. Now, have to reshuffle the orders. Athletes will have to wait around for a short while as officials reshuffle. But Ryan Krauser, I don't think anyone saw that throw coming from Dalam Rahmani. But he knows he's capable of that distance and more. Dalam Rahmani, though, what a throw from him. It was building towards that throughout the first three rounds. What has he got left? Don't go anywhere, because this competition is just getting started. Fourth in Doha, when we saw Three athletes go over 22 meters 90. So much drive out the back, comes around and just absolutely smashes that shot put. Look at it go, sails over that 22. Look at the energy, bouncing around like a gymnast. The intensity this man brings to the event. He's here for business. Leading it so far at the halfway mark then. There are the standings so far. Romani 22.53, Krauser 22.44, and Walsh 22.29. Ryan Krauser, twice Olympic champion, world record holder. Tom Walsh always has a smile on his face. The Kiwi isn't short of a few medals. Opened his account with that 22-29. I've seen it so many times. Did the same in Birmingham 4 years ago. Arshawa Tundi pulling out a great throw. Athletes who aren't in the top three have the option to leave the field. Some like to stick around and watch the show. Darla Romani saying, staying composed. He's probably ready to go bigger again if needed. Important to stay warm as power athlete, keeping that engine ticking over. Whether that's layers, running about, drilling the technique on the track. Thomas Walsh, world champion back in 2017. One of the three men over 22 meters today, including this man, Ryan Krauser. The form he's shown, the distances he's producing, he'd be a brave man to bet against him not winning. But right now, Darlan Romani has put it on him. Ryan Krauser will have three remaining attempts to beat that 22-51-53 of Darlan Romani, the second man to break that championship record to date. Victor Pettersson, Filip Mihailović. Relaxing. Great scenes here. Packed arena. Really embracing the shot put final. And they are being treated to a great competition too. Thomas Walsh. Romani then, top of the leaderboard, 22.53. There are your standings so far. At the halfway mark, Mezat Pezat, 20 meters 94, for eighth place. Those are your top eight. Now, will we see a chop and change in the medals throughout these last three throws? Don't go anywhere. Edge of your seat stuff. The remaining athletes keep warming up, and the athletes that haven't made the top eight will be exiting the arena. Francisco Bello, disappointing day for him. Scott Lincoln will be frustrated too.
shows how great championship performing really is. Championship record mark already been obliterated twice. Will we see someone take that world record mark of Ryan Krauser's 22.82, which he set last year? It's his first indoor worlds. It's Arlen Romani, though. Through 21.71 coming into this. Fifth best mark in the world. He's always missed out on the medals, even though he produces great throws. Josh Awatunde, teammate Ryan Krauser, Filip Mihailović, both just sitting outside the medals in fourth and fifth place. They're both going to need to produce lifetime bests if they want to get into that medals. But the main protagonist so far, Ryan Krauser, Thomas Walsh, Darlan Romani. As we're awaiting to get this fourth round underway, Zane Weir there, 21.34 in the first round, good enough to get sixth. Teammate Nick Ponzio as well, 21.15 for seventh. Mezid Pezza, though, will get the fourth round underway as we go in reverse order. ...20.94 for him. The 2019 Balkan Indoor Champion. No improvement there, takes the deliberate foul. Remains in the same position. Nick Ponzio next into the ring. Two Italians in this final. What can Nick Ponzio produce? No improvement there, and he knew it. Walks straight out the front. Hasn't got quite the rhythm as he did in his 21-meter throw previously. It's another foul. Remains in the seventh position. His teammate then, Zane Weir, be into the ring next. ...21.34 so far. Always coming down a bit too soon, putting it down the right hand side of the sector. There's so much drive out the back though, crowding that stop board, foot coming down. The young Jack O'Gill. Filip Mihailović then asking the crowd for their support. What can the Croat do? 21.51 so far in fifth position. That's a big throw for him. Hands in the air. We saw him foul a 22 meter throw in the last round. Manages to hold that one in the ring. Being such a giant of a man. That is close. And he knew it. 21.83, just a centimetre shy of his season's best. Cements that fourth position.
Come on.
You hear it there, the last two throws will be big throws. Joshua Tundy. Improving as the rounds go on. Just loses the finish, falls out the front, red flags raised. His first foul of the day. 21-70, now down to fifth place. After that improvement from Mihailović. For the first of the three men that are on another level at the moment, Thomas Walsh, 22-29 in the first round, currently in the bronze medal position. Can he take that lead off Darlan Romani? No improvement. Red flag is raised. Knows it wasn't the one. Left leg a bit late to come down. Looks like he slipped a bit out the back of the ring. A guy that really uses all the circle. Still in that bronze medal position with 22-29. A man who didn't think he'd be in second place at the halfway mark with 22-44. Ryan Krauser. It's good to see him under this pressure. Always brings out the best in him as he gathers himself for his fourth round throw. Again, smashing that 22 meter barrier. Doesn't look like it's going to be further than his 22.44, but it's still another 22 meter throw. 22.32, it's no improvement. Still in second position. It only takes one throw. Darlan Romani of Brazil, currently leading proceedings with 22.53 as he closes out this fourth round of throws. Not as good as his previous throw. White flag is raised. As well, the sling, 140 kilos across the ring like that. Knows that was the one, but still leading the event after the fourth round. Mesut Pezet still in eighth position so far. 20 meters, 94 is best. Came in the second round as he gets the fifth round underway. Red flag is raised. He knows it's not further than second round attempt. Came down on the stop board anyway with his left leg. We'll have one remaining attempt.
to see if he can improve on his eighth position so far. Nick Ponzio up next, 21-15. What can he do? Looks like a better throw. Looks around that 21 meter mark. Holds himself well in the ring. ...20-64, no improvement. Wayne Weir will be up next. His teammate. Clock's going. What can Zane Weir do? 21-34 is best in the first round. Has had three series of throws. Starts his fifth round attempt. Oh, a big throw from Zane there, but unfortunately the red flag is raised. Wow. He's definitely got a big throw in him. So much drive out the back. Unfortunately, not being able to hold it. Thinks it was around the 22-30 mark. Doesn't matter though, because it wasn't legal. We'll have one remaining attempt. Filip Melhalovic then asking for the crowd support. 21-83 in the fourth round. Can he get himself with the medals? He's going to need to go 22. Unfortunately, that's not it. Around the 21 meter mark. Doesn't quite get that separation that he had in his previous throw. Another 21 meter throw, but no improvement. 21-03. Still in fourth place with one remaining attempt. Josh Awatundi then demoted to fifth after that throw of Filip Mihailovic. 21-70 for him so far. Foul in the last round. What can he do in the fifth? Second of the US indoor trials. Has pulled it down the left-hand side of the sector all day. The red flag is raised. Does well to stay in the ring. Unfortunately, the shot was into the netting and out of the sector. Red flag will remain in fourth, in fifth place with 21 meters and 70. Here we go, Thomas Walsh in the bronze medal position. 22-29 so far in the first round. What can he do? It's another big 22 meter throw from Thomas Walsh. He knows he's close. It's a respectable throw, a big throw over 22. Don't think it'll be an improvement. It's just shy of that 22 meter line, actually. 21 high. As we await the results, 21-80 then for Thomas Walsh. Has one remaining attempt. Ryan Krauser to follow then. Thomas Walsh knows his big throws there. He's been doing this long enough. Experienced athlete. Ryan Krauser though,
currently in the silver medal position with 22.44, trailing Brazil's Darlan Romani. What can Ryan Krauser do here? Just shy of that 22-meter line. He knows he's frustrated. Red flag is raised. Doesn't even take the valid throw if it's not over the 22-meter mark. It's a good place to be. We'll have one remaining attempt to steal that lead off Darlan Romani. Romani, so composed, so focused, hasn't battered an eyelid. As he enters the ring for his fifth attempt, 22.53 so far. What can he do to close out this fifth round? No improvement on his leading throw. The red flag is raised. Red flag was raised before he'd had a chance to exit the ring. We'll have one remaining attempt. Get ready for the sixth and final round. So much can change in this last round of throw. Tom Walsh, he knows what he needs to do. The defending two-time world indoor champion. Ryan Krauser there, favorite for the win at his first Worlds. But that man, Darlan Romani, upsetting the party. Thomas Walsh as well, reminding everyone. Still one of the greats. Looking very confident, the Kiwi. Feels he can probably do something special in this last round, but Darlan Romani in full control so far. 22.53 for him in this final. Teammate of Ryan Krauser, Josh Awatunde. Currently fifth place overall. He's building a nice series of throws into the third round. Hasn't been able to produce anything further than the latter. There you have the results so far. Your event leader, Darlan Romani, with 22.53. Can Ryan Krauser find something in this last round? As well as Tom Walsh, still in the mix. Still anyone's for the win. Mesut Pezer to get the final round throws underway. 20 meters 94 for him. Can he improve on that position? Looks close as he raises his hands and applauds this tremendous crowd who have supported him and all the athletes. It won't be an improvement on his overall position. 20 meters 70, second best throw of the day, finishes on 20.94 at eighth place. Nick Ponzio then for his final round attempt. 21.15, hasn't been able to find those high 21 meter throws so far. Can he do it in the last round? A lot of emotion gone into that one. It looks like it could be his furthest throw today. Makes himself so big in the ring. Big wide orbit. ...21-30, it is a slight improvement, but not good enough to improve his position. Finishes in seventh place with his teammate Zane Weir to go next. Only 4 centimeters ahead of Nick so far. Can he hold a big throw in the ring? Six years old. What can he do? Well, that's a big throw from Zane Weir. Down the right-hand side of the sector. As we await the distance. Creates so much drive out the back, does so well to stay in the ring. And that looks like it could be close to his best. And it is 21-67.
So I'm glad to give it to you.
I got that next year again. Oh,
yeah. It's no improvement on the position, but his best performance so far coming in the last round. Looks delighted with that throw. Josh Owatunde then, looking for the crowd support as he closes his competition. Can he improve on his 21.70 meters? Pulling it down that left-hand side of the sector. It's over 22 metres, but the red flag is raised. He thought he'd done it. Asking for confirmation of the foul. It was a big throw over the 22-metre mark. Oh, it's awfully close. I believe he'll challenge that foul because it's hard to see with the naked eye. And there you hear it, protest. We'll have to wait to see. It's hard out the back. Left foot comes down in the ring. Switch foot into the stop board. Might have been his right foot on the right-hand side of the sector board. Stop board. His toe might have creeped outside the ring. We'll have to wait and see. Always on the reverse as the athletes try to stay in the ring. But they find the problems. But that was over the 22-meter mark. Whether it would have been good enough for the medals is another question. So far, it stood as a foul. As the officials will review it. Just chatting to teammate Krauser there.
On this side.
So he comes down, drops the left knee out the back, gets the legs right underneath him. It's a very good throw, but as he switches foot, you can see the reverse of the right foot and the toes creep outside to the right-hand side of the stop board. The official would have had a bird's-eye view of that footing. As the video replay shows the other side of the ring. I think it has stood as a foul. Filip Melhanović of Croatia then. 21-83 so far. What can the big man produce? It's another big throw from him, close to that 22-meter mark. It won't be enough to get himself in the medals, but a great performance from him. Could potentially be his best throw today. if not very close to it. 21.83, his best today. 21.81. What a series of throws from him. But now we have our medalists. Thomas Walsh, currently in the bronze medal. Can he improve on his 22.29 in the first round? 22.44 from Krauser in silver. It's another 22 meter throw from Thomas Walsh. Really bringing the fire in the last round. The white flag is raised. Is it good enough to improve his overall standing? 22.29 is best throw so far. Looks close to that distance. 22.31 is a slight improvement, but not good enough to improve his overall position. He is your World Indoor Bronze medalist this time with 22.31, which is the exact same distance that he won the World Championships in Birmingham 4 years ago. Ryan Krauser then didn't think he'd be in second place going into the last round. 22.44 stamped his authority in the first round. Darla Romani responded in the third. What can he do in the sixth round? Oh, it's not to be for Ryan Krauser, and he knows it. We have a new World Indoor Champion, Darla Romani of Brazil, fourth at so many majors. Now he's the gold medalist with 22.53. Can he improve on that in the last round? Can he put on a show for the crowd, who have been tremendous in here tonight? Ryan Krauser there, not quite getting into the groove that we usually see him in. We'll be frustrated with that performance, but 22.44, it's still phenomenal. Shows how much the standard of throwing has come along in the recent years. After he broke the world record, but Darla Romani, the man of the moment. What can he do in this last round? It's another 22-meter throw from Darla Romani. It won't be an improvement, but he is your World Indoor Champion. White flag is raised. Tom Walsh embracing him there. What a competition. Darla Romani. ...22.53 in the third round, 22.18, that final round effort. Thumbs up. Job done. Ryan Krauser, though, will be frustrated with that performance. More than anything, felt he could threaten that world indoor record of his. Just wasn't to be today. Darla Romani, championship record, and your World Indoor Champion, 22.53. Taking the moment in. Special moment for the Brazilian. Has always produced big 22 meter throws. Comes out the back so hard. Gets so much linear speed as a rotational athlete. And really drives big. 22.53 out. And he knew it. That was his final round throw there. For 22.18 to back it up. Thomas Walsh. Your bronze medalist today. 22-29 in the first round, really put the pressure on. 20-31 in the last, but good enough for bronze. Ryan Krauser, though, 22-44. Will he ever become a world champion? I'm sure he will in years to come. A phenomenal thrower. The world record holder, indoor and out. He's only getting more and more experience as he goes along. Thomas Walsh, though, 22-31, the exact same distance that he won the world indoors 4 years ago in Birmingham. Only good enough for bronze today. Great to see him back throwing the 22 meters, though. There you have it, your men's shot put final. Darlan Rahmani, Ryan Krauser and Tom Walsh, your medalists. 22-31 from Thomas Walsh, 22-44 from Ryan Krauser, and Darlan Rahmani with a championship record of 22 meters 53. And there's your final 17 athletes of the men's shot put final.